German emplacement, trenches over there, but there was barbed wire between here and there, and actually the barbed wire acted to arrest the gliders as close as they were. So they recover their senses, and they come running out of their gliders. They know what to do, and they run up on the bridge. And as they run across the bridge, there's a German sentry on the other side, and he throws up his rifle and he ran away. And there's a very good reason for that. He was a new man who came from Eastern Europe, and he had only arrived the day before.
Oh.
And so who will you assign sentry duty to but the man with the least seniority? So that's who he is. So very quickly, they are across the bridge. They take the bridge. And as they're crossing to the other side of the bridge, then you have the first KIA, first killed in action on D-Day, who is a young British lieutenant by the name of Den Brotheridge. And he is shot in the throat and killed us on the other side of the bridge. John Howard knew a lot about Germans who were in this location. He knew about it from various intelligence reports and from aerial photography. But also, there was the Gondre Cafe right over there, which was operated by a man named George Gondre. And what the Germans didn't know, who went in there to have coffee or whatever, was that Madame Gondre had come from Eastern France and that she spoke German. And she listened to what they had to say. She told her husband it was fed into the resistance network, and the information ends up in England. So John Howard knows that the explosives to destroy this bridge are not on the bridge. That they are down here about 50 yards further, and they're stored in a certain location down there. So when you see the movie, The Longest Day, and this is the Hollywood part of it, two British soldiers hang onto the bridge and swing arm to arm across the bridge, a desperate effort to pull out the cords from out of the TNT. That didn't happen. Okay. But John says most of the rest of everything is as it was. While this is going on, a British major Smith, who's been with his girlfriend, he comes driving along this road, and so the British soldiers do what they should do. They kill him, and he falls out of his Jeep. I don't know how many of the German soldiers had been killed. I know they did not kill the sentry who ran away, because eventually they found him a few years ago while there were still survivors around. They found him in Eastern Europe, to come back here and meet with them at midnight and drink champagne on the bridge. And actually brought the guy back here to do that.
Oh my God.
Okay. So again, John Howard's orders were to take the bridge, hold until relieved. He said the next morning, when it began to get daylight, there were three Spitfires, but if you don't know, that's a British fighter plane. Three Spitfires came over, and as they came over, they just did a victory barrel roll. And as they did, a package fell out of each. Three packages fell out, and they were newspapers. So John tells me that story, and I thought, God, that's marvelous. That's a literate society, because he said a bunch of his men just jumped up and ran after those packages. Packages of the newspaper, they would have the news of the invasion, and they would find out how they were being written up in the London newspaper. Don't you believe it? there was a cartoon carried in a certain London newspaper that featured a scantily clad young mouse. His name was Jane, and they were after the next issue of Jane's escapades. That was their story. So John Howard is holding the bridge.